we will talk about some of the troubleshooting tools that are available to you for vSAN. So why are these important? Should you run into any issues with your vSAN cluster, you want to ensure that you can check what these issues are, and in some cases, you will be able to resolve these issues yourself. So for example, let's look at one of the tools, which is the vSphere web client. Now, the vSphere web client is very useful, and we often use it for things like configuration and modifications in our vSAN cluster. We also use it for creating virtual machines. If you need to put a host into maintenance mode, we usually use the web client. But it can be also used for your vSAN cluster, because you can come along and you can take a look at your disk group information, see if there's any failures in those disk groups. You can also check your networking, see if there's a network partition. So these are some of the things that you can do in the vSphere web client. Also in 6.2, vSAN 6.2, you will be able to see the performance charts for vSAN. So you can see these as well in 6.2. Another tool that is available to you is ESXCLI. So you can putty onto your ESX server and you can take a look, put in some of your commands in here and get your output. So let's actually go on to a putty session here and run some of the ESXCLI commands that are useful from a vSAN perspective. We looked at some of these when we were doing the HCL lessons. However, there are other commands that we did not run while we were running the HCL lessons. So let's take a look.